We actually have a list of some of the different treatment options that might be available for patients, and here we see that. We have anticoagulation therapy, thrombolysis, and thrombectomy. So let's again go through each of these one by one. What is anticoagulation therapy?
So those are some pretty big terms.
Yeah. But
anticoagulation therapy is a very complex way of saying you take a blood thinner,
okay,
and it thins your blood out. And that's in fact how 95% of patients are treated. The other two things, thrombectomy and thrombolysis, are terms where that mean we can put a drug into your body much more potent than the anticoagulants and dissolve the clot. And we do that with some of the catheters that you saw in the earlier segment, with the same techniques we do in the arteries. And we either can put a drug in and dissolve the clot, or we have mechanical ways to suck the clot out or to pull it out, and that's the thrombectomy part.
Okay. One question I have, you know, people hear blood thinners, and I feel sometimes they get nervous because they think, I don't want to be on one too long, there might be some side effects. So what would you like to say to people about some of the side effects that do exist, but also by ways that those are monitored, or, you know, to make sure patients don't have complications?
Sure. So if you're prescribed a blood thinner because you have DVT, it's important to take your blood thinner. Again, we don't want the DVT to propagate or progress. So if you're prescribed it, you have to be on it for at least 3 to 6 months, depending on the cause and etiology of the DVT. As far as side effects, there is a risk, increased risk of bleeding associated with taking blood thinners. There are some blood thinners that you can take that do not require monitoring. There are others that you take where you have to get blood drawn routinely once a week or once every 2 weeks in order to ensure that your level of anticoagulation is at the appropriate point.